Some general information about this creature. The name is a blue dragon. The combat level is 111. The max hit with melee and fire breath is 150, but be aware, if you don't wear an anti-dragon shield or dragon fire shield, the fire breath can hit up to 500. So it is necessary you always wear your anti-dragon shield or dragon fire shield. Remember that. Hey guys, it's MoneyKills again, and I'm going to show you how to kill blue dragons. I have two spots for the blue dragons, one in Taverly Dungeon and one in the Ogre Village, next to Castle Wars. I'm going to show you both for the ones who have a little bit more money and the ones who are really poor and really need money. You can get around 500 to 650k per hour, which is really great money. But you'll need a high range to get that amount of money. If you only have like 50 range, I recommend you use like a ranging potion, and then you can make around 400k per hour. But I really recommend you have around 70 range or higher to kill them properly. Still at my level, I use ranging potion just to kill them way quicker. And you always use your anti-dragon shield, don't forget it. I forgot it once and, well, it almost killed me. I'm not going to show you how to melee them, so if you want to know how to melee them, look for a different guide, because I am going to show you how to range them. Range is, in my opinion, a lot more effective. Melee, you need a high melee stats to kill them properly, while you need low range stats to kill them pretty good. Now I have two equipment setups, which is one, the cheap way. If you really have no money at all, this will be your best setup. This will only cost like 100k max, and you will make around 400k per hour, so you can improve your equipment by the hour. Of course, if you have higher range stats, or if you have a higher range level, you can upgrade from green dehide to blue dehide, red dehide, and eventually black dehide. But I just chose this because this is like the basic range gear. Now if you have a little bit more money, you can use this setup, which is a ranged amulet, a black dehide, and an archer helm. For the archer helm, you will need to have done the Fremnic Isles, I thought it was. Still your anti-dragon shield and rune crossbow. If you haven't got a level for the rune crossbow, use like a other type of crossbow, just what fits your level. Now if you have way more money to spend, you can use this setup, which is a DFS, Armadial, Chestplate, and Verex Helm. If you have the money, you can always also buy the Armadial Plate Skirt. But I lost my armor plate skirt when I died, so I will just use this. Now for the equipment, what I bring is one ranging potion for those one beast of burden familiar. I use the spirit herbert. I have the level for a war tortoise, but it's not worth it in my opinion. I use this to get more bones and hides, and emergency food, which is one tuna or trout. Now I'm going to show you how to get there. Just walk from Castle Wars south over the bridge, then just walk east to the village. For this you need to have done the Watchtower quest, which is a really easy quest.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart, but your head gets...
Now that you're here, there are three dragons I use. One to stand behind this pillar and kill it. Now it's dead. I always pick up the hides and bones. Now the second dragon is behind these little spikies and kill it right here. Now this one is dead too. And the third one is behind this pillar and range it like this. I'll see you right back when I have a full inventory. Alright guys, I have a full inventory. Now what you do, you just rub your Ring of Dueling, teleport to Cast Wars, and just repeat. I will show you what this inventory made me. Alright, this inventory made me 131k, and it took me exactly 10 minutes, so just multiply this by 6 and you'll know how many you will make per hour. Alright, now for the second place where you can kill blue dragons, you will need some requirements. 65 agility, but I really recommend you have 70 plus, so you can use the shortcut to the blue dragons, and you will need a lot of Falador teleports. If you have 65 agility and not 70, you will use your summer pie to boost your agility level by 5 to get through the shortcut. Now first climb over this crumbling wall and head northwest. You are now below Teverly, and you'll go into the Teverly dungeon, which is this ladder. Now, this is the shortcut I want to talk about. I'm not going to show you the long way, so if you want to know that, just look at the world map. Eat your summer pie and crawl through. Now here it will be a little bit more crowded, so yeah, this is not really the best spot in my opinion. I would really go with the other one, but if you haven't done the quest, you can use this spot